Hey traders, I'm currently watching Pound Swiss Pair, and in my view here we have just the perfect example of a top-down trade. In this video I will show you how we trade the top-down analysis. I will show you how do we properly set the stop loss, how do we select the entry, and how do we select the targets. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Let's start. So when we treat the top-down analysis, we always start with the higher time frame. And the higher time frame that I prefer is the daily chart. Daily chart is one of my favorite trading charts. There I look for the key levels, there I look for the market trend. And here our task is to identify the recent major key levels. And to do that, we simply follow the price action. We match the recent highs and lows, and with that we are trying to identify the points that the market respected in the past. And you can see that recently the price was trading in a local strong bullish trend, yes, and just after that the price managed to violate the previous high low to the downside. And you know, for the market participants, for the price action traders right now, it's kind of a strong bearish clue. So what is important for us to realize is that right here this last high low was a very strong structure support. You can see that in the past we saw very strong bullish reactions from that structure. In many times, once the price reached that support, we saw very nice bullish movements, and the price even managed to set a new structure high right here once that structure was reached. Recently though, we see the breakout of that structure to the downside. Bears managed to violate that structure, and right now, according to our classic rules, that structure turned into resistance. So right now the price is testing that structure resistance. The price is trading on that structure resistance, and chances are high that the market will drop from that structure. So it is the first step of the top-down analysis. We are looking for the key levels, key daily levels, and we wait until the key level is reached. Here on the Pound Swiss, the market reached the key level. So now our task is to analyze lower time frame, and there we must look for the confirmation that the structure is respected. Hey guys, if you want to learn top-down analysis, if you want to master this trading approach, I want to invite you in my premium educational group. There you will see how I analyze the market live, and there you will see how I apply top-down analysis live on different financial instruments. I will show you how I trade with the top-down analysis, and I will show you how to properly apply price action and structure trading in a combination with the top-down trading. All the links are in the description below. Check vasilytrader.com/private group or contact me in one of the social networks. I really want you to join. Let's continue. I'm on the 4-hour chart, and here we see in details the recent price action, and we see how the price reacted to the daily key structure that we identified. And as you can see, once our key structure was reached, you see that the price stopped growing. We saw quite impressive bullish movement right here. We saw quite strong bullish candles on the 4-hour. But once the price reached our zone, we see a sequence of doji candles, we see the rejection, and definitely it is a very important clue, and it definitely tells us that some traders started to sell or some buyers stopped buying, and it made the market stop growing, yes. But what else do we have? If we follow the price action on the 4-hour, if we just analyze the recent price action right here, we can see that we have a lot of structure levels right here. You can see that the price was coiling here for quite a while. We saw that the price was boiling right here, and recently it reached our major key level. So why do I draw this price fluctuations right here? Because it is very important for you to realize that over here we have structure support. You can see that just recently that structure was a very strong resistance. Yes, we saw the bearish reaction from that. And recently that structure was broken to the upside. So technically speaking right now, the price is trading between two key levels. It is trading between the major daily structure and between the local 4-hour recent structure. Yes, And technically speaking, we cannot see exactly where the price will go next, because the intraday buyers, they definitely buy from this support, but the daily time frame traders, they sell from this resistance. So what do we do in this kind of situation? Let's zoom in the chart and discuss this price action in details. And though we just concluded that it is quite hard to see where the market will go next because of those two structure levels, top-down analysis helps us, because on a daily chart we already identified that the market is trading on a very strong resistance. So definitely we are on the bearish side right here. However, to catch this bearish movement, we need the confirmation. Yes, because for now we have the contradiction on the 4 hours. So what do we need right here? We should look for the trend lines, we should look for the patterns that will help us to get some confirmation. So technically speaking, we will be writing our predictions once this horizontal support will be broken to the downside. So definitely we need the 4 hour structure breakout of this yellow area, and only after that bearish continuation will be expected. Moreover, if we pay close attention to the recent lows right here, you can see that we have this very nice rising support. Yes, and moreover, if we add one more trend line right here, you can see that the price here is trading within this rising wedge pattern. Moreover, you can see that right here we have a perfect foundation for a double top formation with the lower high. So once the price breaks the support, this underlined yellow support, it will match with the breakout of this wedge pattern, and it will match with the breakout of this of the neckline of the double top. So we will have a lot of different clues telling us the same thing. And this is what we are looking for with the top-down analysis. We are looking for different signals telling us exactly the same thing. So we are waiting here for the breakout of this yellow structure cluster. Once we see the 4-hour candle close, yes, and we strictly need the 4-hour candle close right here, 4-hour candle close below. Once we see the 4-hour candle close below right here, we can place our sell limit on the retest. And here, you know, it is always the speculation about where is the exact entry. I prefer to base my entry on the neckline of the pattern. And here we have this potential double top formation. Here we have its neckline. So for me, it is the best entry. But of course, you can play with that. You can play with the retest of the broken support of the wedge. You can play with the lower boundary of the structure that we identified. You know, it is very kind of subjective thing, and different traders apply different entries here. But I strictly prefer the retest of the neckline or of the pattern. In my view, it is the safest one and the best one. So my stop will be strictly above the highs right here. Yes, we have our daily structure cluster right here, and to make our position very safe, to make it safe, we need to place our stop above the highs right here, so that we could have a very strong protection of a daily structure of the local 4-hour structure of the trend line, so that, you know, it would be very hard for the market maker to stop hunt us. And where will be our initial goal for the trade right here? For the initial goal, we will aim at the closest strong structure. And if we execute our analysis on the 4-hour, we are looking for the 4-hour structure. Yes, our closest 4-hour structure is right here. You can see how decent structure support right here we have. And based on its candle closes, will be our first goal for the trade. So you can see that we have quite decent risk to reward, but we will close just half of our trading position on this first goal. But let's check daily chart and let's check where can be our second goal. So our second target here will be the next strong daily structure support. And you can see that here is our next strong daily structure and here will be our second goal for our trade. And let's return back to the 4-hour and just measure risk to reward for our second target. So you can see that here, if we execute the risk to reward analysis for the second target, we will have quite decent risk to reward. So as you can see with the top-down trading, we are looking for a lot of different confirmations. We are looking for the breakouts, we are looking for the violations of some minor structure levels. And the point why we do that, we are trying to avoid contradiction. We are waiting for the moment when all the things tell us the same thing. Yes, we are waiting for the moment where when it is naturally no reason for buyers to buy. Yes, with all these breakouts for buyers, there will be no sense to buy, technically speaking. And this is the moment when we ended the trade. And yes, it requires to be extremely patient. Yes, it requires to wait. But at the end of the day, you will get the very high accuracy of your trading predictions. So I guess that is why it is so important to practice top-down analysis in trading. Alright traders, that's it. Thank you so much for watching. If you want to learn top-down analysis, if you want to master the top-down approach, don't forget to check my premium educational group, all the links in the description below. Thank you so much. Like this video, subscribe to my YouTube channel, and I will see you on weekend.